Please remain standing for O Canada. Please be seated. As they take their seats, please join me in recognizing the grade 5 strings musicians and Miss Fisher, our junior school strings teacher. Thank you for playing so beautifully. Mr. Turner, Board of Governors, faculty and staff, parents and grandparents, friends, and most importantly, to the students of the junior school, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to the 2019 closing ceremonies. We acknowledge that our school rests in the heart of Strait Salish territory, a living culture with its own rites, ceremonies, and unfolding history. We honor the Esquimalt, Songhees, and Wasanich peoples whose homelands we share and whom we recognize as our neighbors. We come together today to celebrate a rewarding year of children's learning, exploring, playing, making friends, and being good people. In particular, we want to recognize our grade 5 students as they prepare to call this campus their home in September. There are many factors that go into a successful school year, and this one had them all. To begin, I would like to recognize the contributions of our dedicated faculty, committing time and energy beyond expectations to ensure a rigorous academic, artistic, and athletic program for our students. Our faculty consider the best ways to present inspiring learning opportunities within and beyond the walls of the school. Students leave the junior school with a solid set of skills as learners and develop and stretch themselves as individuals. With an ability to pull hidden and undiscovered talents from our children, our teachers develop the whole child in a skillful and loving way. Thank you. I would also like to recognize Ms. Squire, Ms. Lewis, and Mr. Ewing. Thank you for going out of your way to create a welcoming atmosphere and having the highest expectations of your work in your respective areas of the school. We are all grateful and benefit daily as you keep us functioning so well. Another factor that contributes to a successful school year is our parent community. You are the strength of our school. We are so glad to be partnered with you on this important journey with your child. We share the belief that we build community with children at the center. You are engaged and connected. We appreciate your gifts of time, talent, and treasures. Our students have a love of school and show so many positive qualities, and we know this starts at home. Thank you. It has also been wonderful to welcome our head of school, Mr. Turner and Mrs. Turner, this year. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Mr. Turner for getting to know the junior school this year, taking time to look, listen, and learn. It's been great. One long-serving staff member will be leaving us, and I would like to recognize his service to the school. Gordon Chan has worked for the past 22 years in various roles at the junior school. Over his long career, he taught social studies, was a home form teacher, and most recently, our technology coordinator. Gordon has taken every opportunity to move with the times. He served as the school's digital and computer expert, helping staff transition from the use of chalkboards and overhead projectors and the occasional floppy disk to meaningfully integrating digital technology into the classroom. More recently, he has been much appreciated also as the junior school's photographer, capturing special moments in daily school life and school events. Gordon is looking forward to spending more time with his wife, Margaret, and sons, Zachary, Jordan, and Adam. And I would like to thank Gordon for his contributions to the junior school and St. Michael's University School. We wish Gordon all the best in his retirement. This has been an exciting year at the junior school. It doesn't take more than a walk through the building at any given time to get a sense of the incredible learning and opportunities, from hatching chicks and ducks, to raising and releasing butterflies, to learning from First Nations elder Bill White, to gardening, to beach walks and sit spots, to advocating for our marine health at World Oceans Day and developing our outdoor survival skills. In these and many other ways, our children connected their learning with nature this year. With the library and Imagination Lab as a hub of learning, students researched, designed, coded, created, and innovated. Objects that came out of the iLab ranged from elaborate robots coded to take on predetermined tasks, to hand-drawn butterflies that were laser-cut, to boats that should float and hand-sewn stuffies and creative videos filmed in front of a green screen. Students established their comfort and confidence, developing skills and using materials, tools, and technology. Who knows where these skills will take them? Our students approached mathematical problems with flexible thinking and the ability to use multiple strategies. They succeeded in math contests and developed growth mindsets. They fine-tuned editing skills and produced final paragraph edits to be proud of. They performed French skits, studied various aspects of graphic novels. They developed a love for reading, and many recited personal poems. Extra support or a challenge was there when it needed to be, and a solid and enriched academic foundation was formed. The beautiful work displayed in the foyer, the sound coming from the music room, and the performances that we enjoyed provided regular reminders of the capability of our young artists. And finally, speaking of performers, we are still buzzing about the amazing job our grade 5 students did performing Shrek on the professional stage of the McPherson Theater. There were many other accomplishments. Some may be less tangible or measurable, subtle moments on the sports field or around the school. We are so proud of your inquisitiveness, our students, their character development, and their demonstrations of leadership. It's been a great year. It is here where I'd like to specifically address our grade 5 students who are moving on from the junior school. We have recently been talking about the word legacy. These times of transition provide a good opportunity to reflect on the positive impact this group has had and the legacy they are leaving. This group of students has changed the school in many positive ways. Two examples. Last April, a few of our current grade 5 students came to me with a request to allow girls to wear gray pants to school as part of their number one uniform. They were clear and passionate, and their justifications were well thought out. This suggestion was brought forward to our faculty and approved. Around the same time, I noticed in my calendar a meeting request from a group of grade 4 students wanting to discuss basketball. They had mapped out how they imagined adding more basketball nets to the school and wanted to see what was possible. That small idea sparked more work with the grade 4 classes. We knew we wanted to update our outdoor space, and they looked ahead to their grade 5 year, completed a design thinking process to reimagine what that could look like, and thinking of all the various stakeholders, the constraints of space, their goal was to create an inviting, fun, and functional space that better reflected the values of our school. The result, after support from the school and donors, has been a wonderfully inspired and redesigned outdoor space. We will think of them when we are enjoying our gardens, playing basketball, performing on the outdoor stage, digging in the sandboxes, or jumping from log to log. Lastly, they are leaving a legacy of Shrek, a fun musical with important messages reminding us to be ourselves, be a good friend, and that there are many adventures ahead for all of us. We write our own story. Thank you all for your contributions, your kindness, and your intelligence. We are confident you are well equipped for the adventures to come at the middle school. It has been a privilege to watch you grow in learning this year. Your teachers and parents are immensely proud of you. Thank you very much. At this point, I would like to ask Mrs. Cook, our assistant director, to come to the podium to begin the certificate presentations. Thank you.
Students will be receiving certificates later on after dismissal, and for now we would like to recognize them, and we will begin with recognizing the grade 4 classes. And I invite Shelley Berlin, SMU board member, to the stage, and we will begin with Ms. Newsom's grade 4 class. James Ashwin. Lachlan Bell. Arpit Birdie. Samara Gackle. Zeus Hissen. Elliot Judson. Hannah Kipling, Truman LeBrun, Apollon Liu, Kieran Mackay, Sophia Mainprize, Helen MacArthur, Elspeth Roger, Wolfgang Rogers, Ming Sang, Mia Wong, Iris Wu, Adam Zilber. Congratulations to our 4N class. Thank you, 4N. Now we will recognize Ms. Sanquist's grade 4 class. Just give them a minute to sit down. Eli Alexander. Max Arndt, Samnit Birdie, Bowen Calder, William Delisle,
Savannah Ferguson, Adrian Lai, Melada Lampa, Joshua Leung, Tiffany Liu, Drew McLeese Shaw, Karen Pan, Isabella Parfit, Kate Porter, Rio Robbins, Lorenzo Rogers, Finley Swallow, Jay Tatra, and Ralia Valava. Congratulations to the 4S class. I would now invite Dan Sheehan, SMU Board Vice Chair, to the stage to congratulate the grade 3 classes.
Thank you, Shelley.
We will begin with Mrs. Galloway and Ms. Middleton-Jones' class. Farah Chung, Ava Crawford, Amelia Evans, Amelia Fisher Frank, John Hindy, Liam Kingsbury, Mateo Laca Sweats, Sydney Martin, Matthew Nacy, Clara Priscello, Evan Priscello, Addie Tate, Sakura Tanaka, Jack Traconi, Charlie Wagner, Brandon Wong, Michaela Yee. Congratulations to the 3GM class. We will now recognize Mrs. Kingsbury's grade 3 class. Bonnie Bawa, Catherine Gorenska, Hamish Henderson, Olivia Hunter, Manav Kang, Alex Mackay, Stephanie Mackay, Maho Masuda, Lisa Pai, Deshauna Pillay, Victoria Ramirez Garcia, Isaac Wren, Karsten Roger, Jasper Skomalski, Audra Stewart, and Jonah Wilkins. Congratulations to the 3K class. And thank you, Dan. We will now recognize the grade 2 classes, and I invite Ewan Halliday, head boy, and Morgan Warner, head girl, to the stage. And we will begin with Mrs. Tripp's grade 2 class. Annabelle Bailey Craig, Grace Crawford, Piper Geddes, Isabel Juteau, Colton Kuyak, Lauren Lee, Tristan Lobb, Kaylee Mackay, Tommy MacArthur, Zoe Funuf, Jackson Quacksister, Olivia Sturgis, Emma Sun, and Ethan Venegas. Congratulations to the 2T class. Now we will recognize Ms. Duffus's grade 2 class. Lauren Arndt, Ying Shan Bai, Reese Beer, Silka Ben, Kian Harris, Christopher Hodgins, Tristan Humphreys, Jamie Johnston, Daniel Cricken, Grayson Lee, Gabrielle MacArthur, Anya Oshkai, Abby Portress, Oscar Priscello, Sam Richardson, and Nina Trinder. Congratulations to the 2D class. I now invite Jennifer Trottier from the Junior School Parents Auxiliary to the stage to help recognize the grade 1 students. And we will begin with Ms. Porteous's grade 1 class. Thank you. Rakshit Arun, Parthiv Chandra, Ryan Curtis, Noah Delisle, Sarah Evans, Sienna Evans, Maya Cruz, Frank Leung, Marcus Liberatore, Jack Parfit, Matthew Poon, Isla Robbins, Anya Seti, Calla Steele Beck, Shep Stooksbury, Lucas Way. Congratulations to the 1P class. Now we will recognize Mrs. Smith's grade 1 class. Ada Alexander, Victoria Arnasia, Benson Benab, Leah Kao, Hugo Danzo Dvorak, Grady Dickinson, Mateo Fountain, Chloe Gao, Stephen Haley, Oliver Keel, Emmett Kipling, Phoebe Swallow, Claire Van Ralt, Eben Watson, Jacob Yao. Congratulations to the 1S class.
Thank you, Jennifer.
Now I invite Mr. Turner, head of school, to recognize the kindergarten students. And we will begin with Ms. Eden's kindergarten class. Sway Brunton. Kate Crawford, Sophia Fountain, Jackson Hunter, Ella Johnston, Isla Kingsbury, Lucas Lacasuetz, Shang Shang Liu, Elizabeth Marks, Angus McCracken, Elliot Wren, Gavin Walsh, Marcus Wilkins, Alma Zilber. And congratulations to the KE class. And now we will recognize Mrs. O'Donnell's kindergarten class. Tessa Chung, Elise Bailey Craig, Alia Gill, Estella Gosniak, Jordan Hunter, Ethan Lai, Ariana Lalani, Kalia Lewis, Dane Martin, Thea Picardi, Kate Presley, Marquesa Travelby, James Webb, and Eli Zilber, congratulations to the KO class. And I now invite Mr. Turner, head of school, to the podium.
Mrs. Cook, thank you very much indeed. And what a privilege that was to be able to shake hands with the future talent for SMU. Those starting their journey at our school, as you can appreciate, I spend most of my time on this campus seeing the grade 12s and those that are about to exit. But a real privilege to be able to shake hands with those that are beginning to start their journey through our school. So thank you for that. And I'd also like to acknowledge the member of faculty who this afternoon, when we were in here, suggested that the sign saying, "Beware the ogre," which is somewhere down here, I think, should be right here during the time that I'm speaking to you. So I'm delighted that we didn't actually move forward with that, but that would have intimidated me a little bit. But good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. I have to confess that this is a very difficult speech for me to write. And one of our key values here is honesty, so I have to be truthful to that. It was very difficult to write because there is so much that I want to say, and your director of the junior school has been very precise in telling me that I have 7 minutes flat. So I've had to cut out a huge amount of what I wanted to share with you, but nevertheless, I hope I'm able to seize a few nuggets here this afternoon. It's wonderful to be here to celebrate the achievements of our junior school boys and girls individually, grade five specifically, and the school collectively over what must go down as a record year by many criteria. There is a phrase, tempus fugit, time flies. And if it's true that time flies when you're enjoying ourselves, then we've had a wonderful year. In August, Elizabeth and I arrived disorientated and jet-lagged, and since then, we've almost finished the hamper that was left to us by the parents' auxiliary. I say almost because that tells you the size of the hamper that was left on our doorstep as we arrived. It was truly massive and very generous. But it also refers to the fact that almost every day since then, I've been at a function that requires me to eat for Smoo. And I'm thinking of having a t-shirt made saying, I eat for Smoo for the future. During the last few months, I've also had the opportunity to learn some Canadian phrases. And I'm grateful here to my SLT colleagues for allowing me to practice on them. One of the phrases I haven't yet mastered, but which is key to the Canadian phraseology, is the word awesome. And I've tried to get that right, awesome, but I can't quite do it. So I'll keep practicing, and next year you can test me to see if we've made any progress against that. I've also very much enjoyed my crossing guard duties, and I've actually completed 19 of those, not that I'm counting, but it's an interesting factoid, I think, that on none of those Fridays when I've been on crossing guard duty has it rained yet. That's something, again, I hope to continue next year. And I've also come to know the censorship of the SMU Communications and Marketing Department, because in my first newsletter to you, I wrote, I enjoyed my first crossing guard. I'm delighted to report, more by luck than judgment, casualties were light. And this was taken out as not politically correct. As anyone who's read any of my newsletters will know, my tactic this year has been LLL, looking, listening, and learning, an oft-repeated mantra. I knew it was working when some of the students here at the senior school started saying to me, good morning, Mr. Turner, have a really lovely LLL day. And it's really entered the lexicon of smooth phrases. So what have I found through LLL? And I thought I'd just address a little bit of feedback to the three elements of what I'm used to calling the educational tripod. The students here in front of us, the school, and also a few words directed especially to you, the parents. So first of all, to the students. To all students, K to five, I can report that I've learnt to be really impressed by you all. In fact, I'm proud of you all. From my first assembly, when I brought along two of my prized possessions, a dinosaur egg and a cannonball, you showed intellectual curiosity. You asked some great questions, and I was really impressed by that. Since then, I've attended spectacular concerts, vocal and instrumental, and many individual contributions, where always you have showed poise, panache, and unusual confidence for your age and stage. I've learnt that you're charming. Reports from open days suggest that the hosts are one of our best sales points. People love the way that you're able to interact. I've enjoyed learning about your concern for the environment. It's not every school that has a butterfly release program and manages to breed young ducks and chickens. Your concern for others, the soup collections, the fundraising, the beach cleaning, awareness about things beyond school, and the leadership, the grade five's leadership, really impressed me. Your individuals who will go on and play a great role in our school in future years, and I'm sure beyond that in your communities and professions. And I've seen athleticism, great team and individual performances, a wonderful sports day. Back to our motto, a healthy body and a healthy mind. It was really impressive indeed. And then to Shrek. It's my first chance to address you all after Shrek, and all I can say is, wow. That was a wonderful demonstration of community effort, teamwork, talent, and trust, and all delivered with amazing joie de vivre. You enjoyed doing what you were doing, and that communicated itself to those of us very fortunate enough to be in the audience. Shrek, of course, is a wonderful romp, but it is in fact based on a collection of fairy stories and fables passed down over 1,000 years. They're stories about the epic quest, the journey, the fight for justice over injustice, overcoming adversity, the acceptance of everybody for who they are. And I think one of the reasons that maybe that was such a massive success was that those principles resonate with the values on the stage behind me. So I'm going to move on now from the students, but just as I start to talk about the school and the parents, I'm going to leave the students with a riddle that I'll come back to. And the riddle says, what walks on four legs in the morning, two legs at lunchtime, and three legs in the evening? And I'll come back to you on that one. So the second leg of this great tripod, the school. The first thing I learned about the school is that the role is full. We have record wait lists at key points of entry. And as our consultant, commissioned by the Board of Governors to give us feedback, said, that's a sign that you must be doing something right. That was fantastic. The Board of Governors commissioned this survey, arguably the biggest undertaken by a school in Canada, to get a great deal of background information that we can use as we construct our next strategic plan. Looking, listening, and learning on a grand scale. We learnt a lot, and just a couple of quotes. There'll be more feedback during the fall, but for now, our consultant wrote saying, SMU meets or exceeds expectations for the vast majority of its parents and students. And I was particularly keen to ask, how do we do against other international schools? And the answer came back that against the leading junior school in the UK, one I know very well, a school called The Dragon, our levels of satisfaction and achievement were higher than they measured for that school, which is regarded as a leading example of its type. She also wrote, children are empowered in their learning, guided by an excellent and engaged staff who go to great lengths to individualize each child's learning journey. A fantastic statement. And although the year's been devoted to looking and listening and learning, there was one crucial decision taken by the board, and that is that the junior school will stay on its current site. I think it's fantastic that we have a site where we can put all our resources and our facilities to the benefit of junior school-aged students. We can really create an environment that is age appropriate. And it was also interesting during this survey to find that the bits of our school that you, the parents, tell us are weakest. You applauded the curriculum, you applauded the faculty, you applauded the community. But you did have questions about the portables, the inadequate loos, and the classroom with no outside light. That makes me tremendously optimistic, because those are things that we can fix, and I'm looking forward to the opportunity to do just that. And so, to the third of our legs of our tripod, the parents. I'm very grateful indeed for all your support in all sorts of ways. Attendance at numerous events. 71% of you replied to our questionnaire, the best figures of any of our sections, so give yourselves an extra cookie for that. And I thought that it was wonderful that you've also supported our school through word of mouth. Again, our consultant told us that our best advertising is word of mouth, and we were told that you speak very enthusiastically on our behalf, and I'm tremendously grateful for that. And our annual fund looks set to meet its targets this year. Many of you most generously contribute, and that money will be used directly to the benefit of your sons and daughters and our students. I believe that we're set for exciting times. We have an excellent opportunity with our new plan to build on many positives, the positives of our community, our dedicated faculty, and the inspiring leadership of our director. With some targeted investment, and with that, I believe that we can make our very good school even greater. There's a quote attributed to an Irish poet, W.B. Yeats, which says, education is not the filling of a pail, but the lighting of a fire. And from what I've learned this year, SMU Junior School fully embraces this ethos. Firefighters on their fire prevention courses, and believe me, I've attended many of those, talk of the fire triangle contributing to combustion. You have to have fuel, heat, and air. And I think we provide the fuel through the structure of our rigorous curriculum, the heat, the spark of inspiration through that curiosity I've mentioned, and the air is the flow of constant encouragement and guidance from our faculty and staff. So in conclusion, I congratulate our students and faculty on their collective achievements. And to the grade fives moving on, I would give you one piece of advice. Never lose that spark of curiosity, because together, as you move through the middle school to the senior school, we can fan that spark into a flame. Thank you very much indeed. So, to conclude, to the students, anybody know the answer to my riddle? Yes, a random hand in the middle here. Yes, give me a shout out an answer. Bingo, absolutely right. Next year I'll have a more difficult one.
Thank you, Mr. Turner. Please stand for the school hymn.
Please be seated. It is now time to present the Grade 5 certificates. Our Grade 5 students will receive a commemorative book to remind them of their special time at the junior school. In addition, each student will receive a personalized record of achievement booklet, which will outline their participation and/or special recognitions in the following areas. Co-curricular activities, which include sports teams and clubs, service and leadership activities, such as our student ambassador program, leadership responsibilities and community service, outstanding contribution in individual subjects, where students have consistently made an outstanding contribution to class, distinction in individual subject areas, where students have demonstrated exceptional academic performance in a particular curriculum area. And finally, recognition for one of the major awards, such as the Curl Simon Citizenship Cup, the Alumni Association Award, the Slegg Bowl, the Dreen Metcalf Award, the Outstanding Athlete Award, and the M.A. Bridgman Memorial Award. When called upon, each student will come forward to receive their record of achievement and commemorative gift from Mrs. Anderson. As the students come forward, the homeroom teachers will share a few words about each student. I now invite Mr. Keel to come to the podium to introduce the 5K class.
Julian Bizot, come on up. In class, Julian is a quiet and talented learner who always has a smile on his face. Often surprising himself with his capabilities, he's a modest and positive role model for his peers. In school, he loves art and phys ed, and outside of school, Julian enjoys playing tennis. Feng Yi Chu. Feng Yi is a disciplined student who loves art and French class. She is creative and kind and loves spending time with her friends. Outside of school, she's a very talented synchronized swimmer who competes at the provincial level. Ethan Curtis. Ethan is a person who lives to be challenged. His enthusiasm for learning and determination are an inspiration to those around him. He loves basketball and soccer, and it's safe to say that he loves phys ed. Other classes that Ethan enjoys are art and math. Sophie Delonier. Sophie is a very enthusiastic and determined student who has an absolute love for learning. She works very hard at her schooling and always produces exceptional work. She is honest and kind and loves sailing, basketball, and horseback riding. Pema Dolker. Pema is a very responsible, helpful, and considerate student. Inside the classroom, she is a quiet observer of all who loves reading and choir class, but nothing makes Pema more happy than turning up the music, especially K-pop, and having her very own dance party with her friends. Samantha Han. Samantha absolutely loves to read. More often than not, you'll find her deeply buried in a book and off on a distant adventure. She's a kind and quiet student who loves art class. She loves horseback riding and all things to do with horses. Finley Halanen. Finley is kind-hearted and he began the year quite quietly. As the year progressed, we were introduced to his sense of humor and his personality. Now, it's not uncommon to see Finley start an impromptu dance party. His energy and his smile have lit up our classroom. Priya Kaur. Priya is a confident person who loves to make everyone who surrounds her happy. With her sense of humor and her caring demeanor, she is a friend to everyone she meets. She enjoys mathematics and sports and is also a very lovely ballet dancer. Matthew Cricken. Words that come to mind when describing Matthew are gentle, kind, and caring. He's a quiet student, but those who know him well know that he has a very clever sense of humor. He loves art and PE, and outside of school, he's an active member of the Cubs organization. Luke Lee. It's hard for me to use words to explain how much Luke loves sports. Soccer and baseball are definitely at the top of his list. Luke also has impeccable sportsmanship, which carries over to his friendships. He's a very loyal and trustworthy friend who will go out of his way for anyone who is in need. Jordan Martin. Jordan is a diligent worker who loves school. Always one with a smile on his face, his sense of humor brought many laughs to our classroom this year. Jordan loves phys ed and math, and has a special love for running, especially sprint races. Emily McMillan. Emily is a dedicated student who loves art class and has found a new love for mathematics. Emily is a kind and loyal friend whose positive outlook shines through her smile and her laughter. Outside of school, she enjoys playing the piano and singing. William Manette. To me, William personifies determination. Never one to complain about anything, whether it be a simple math challenge, a new concept that he's working through, or even injury, he never quits. His positive attitude and work ethic have been an inspiration to our class. Jillian Murphy. Jillian is a very hard worker and is always trying to better herself. She's quick-witted and has a wonderful sense of humor. She loves drama and math class, and Jillian is one who perseveres through challenges and always gives her best. Molly Pollock. Molly is one of our quiet leaders. Always one to get down to work and put forth her best effort, she is dedicated to her schooling. She loves anything to do with the arts. Acting, singing, and art class are a list of her favorite things in life. Braylon Rowan. Braylon is a leader in so many ways. She's a confident, kind, and honest friend. With her cool and calm demeanor, she is known among her friends as someone they can always lean on. Braylon has a lovely singing voice, and when she performs, she commands the stage. Ryan Chariati. Ryan lives for sports. To say that he's a sports fanatic is an understatement. It should be no surprise that PE tops the list for the award of best class ever. Ryan is a kind and generous friend to all, and he always goes out of his way to ensure that everyone around him is supported. Elliot Tate. Elliot is a talented swimmer, and it's highly probable that he will be competing again at the provincial level this August. Elliot loves being creative. He has a keen artistic ability and loves imagining and creating things, making art class his favorite. Madison Tricconi. Madison is a dedicated student who is incredibly determined to persevere through any challenge thrown her way. She's a caring individual who enjoys surrounding herself with those who share her zest for life. Possessing a strong passion for the arts, she especially enjoys dance, performance, and singing. Annie Tui. Annie is a hard worker who enjoys art class and mathematics. Although a quiet person, once you get to know her, you will see that she's a kind soul with a wonderful sense of humor. Some of the things that Annie loves the most in this world are her cat, gymnastics, and spending time with her friends. Isabel Wu. Isabel lives for a math challenge that will test her skills or teach her something new. She loves reading and is also a talented swimmer who competes at the provincial level. Isabel plays the piano and also the pipa. Something that I'll miss is how Isabel's laugh fills a room and brings a smile to everyone's face. Congratulations, 5K.
I would now invite Mr. Hawes to the podium to introduce the 5H class.
Maddie Angus. Maddie can often be seen with a pencil in hand. He is constantly creating or refining a new character or image. The same focus and attention to detail can be seen in his work in the classroom. His playful exuberance draws people to him. Jada Aylesworth. Jada enjoys working with her hands, creating or drawing. The way she tackles challenges speaks to her desire to do her best. Her calm exterior is backed up by a strong sense of self, and yet a playful sense of humor emerges in a moment's notice with a wry smile. Yingfan Bai. Yingfan joined our school this year. She is a diligent student with a silly sense of humor, a silly streak that endears her to her classmates. Her active involvement throughout the school was wonderful to see. Whether through leadership, sports, or in the classroom, she will give her very best in every situation. Maya Beer. Maya's joyful smile and boundless energy are balanced with a focused attention to detail and a determination to give her best. She is a talented athlete who enjoys being active. Her fun sense of humor and the friendly way she includes others endears her to her classmates. Anderson Brown. Anderson actively participates in group discussions. He is engaged in contributing ideas. His dedication and skill in squash was displayed at the provincial tournaments where he competed against older players and did very well. That same desire to succeed fuels his work in the classroom. Hasmita Chandra. Hasmita is a talented student who is careful in her work, even though she might have us believe that she'd rather be doing something else. Her quick humor and fun-loving nature help make our classroom a delightful place to be. Cindy Chen. To say Cindy is focused on her studies would be an understatement. The way she applies herself and looks for ways to refine her work is outstanding. She also has a wonderfully silly side and is able to balance those two attributes both in her writing and in the classroom. Clara Curry. Clara's determination to give her best has been appreciated. She is actively involved in a variety of sports and brings that same effort and involvement to the playing field. Underneath the quiet exterior is a playfulness that emerged with her friends throughout the year. Peyton Driscoll. While Peyton has a silly side that draws people to her, she also has a resolve to produce very good work. The way she engages in group discussions gets others involved in thinking. Her passion for all things Harry Potter has helped draw others into that wonderful world. Tommy Eaton. Tommy is quick with numbers and enjoys applying his ability. Over the year, he became more and more willing to tackle difficult and complex problems. He showed this same focus when developing his passion for basketball or settling in with an engaging book. Kalina Gackle. Callie is a dedicated and creative student who applies herself in every situation. She is a great listener and has a strong sense of self that has been wonderful to see. Her funny and silly sides emerge as she gets to know you. Her talent with creating and drawing is always present. Finley Henderson. It was fun to discover the playful side that lurks beneath Finley's calm exterior. He is careful to attend to details and applies himself readily in his schoolwork. His writing includes clever details that entertain and draw the reader into the world he creates. Eliana Lobb. Ellie is a kind and considerate student determined to give her best. The emotion and clever plot twists in her creative writing captured our imaginations. Whether embracing the sport of the season or tackling a tricky math problem, she is ready and willing to apply her considerable skill to each task. Quinn McMeekin. Quinn is a dedicated and talented athlete with a love for many sports. He also has a silly and fun-loving nature that ensures that he has a group of people around him quite often. The focus and attention he gave to his schoolwork this year produced very good results. Parker Sheehan. Parker's active involvement in the school was wonderful. Whether through leadership opportunities or the many sports he played, he was committed, engaged, and doing his best. Applying his many talents combined with a sense of fun was how he approached the classroom. Matthew Stark. Matthew is a determined student who strives to do his best. As Shrek in our musical, he took risks and showed a dedication that produced great results on stage. When he has a clear goal in mind, he works tirelessly to achieve it, both in his creative endeavors and in the classroom. Georgia Stridel. Georgia's energy and enthusiasm can fill the room and help others feel like they belong. She's a diligent student with many talents. Whether participating in after-school sports and clubs or simply including others, her reliability and generosity of spirit is evident in all that she does. Julian Trinder. Julian is a calm and thoughtful student who gives his best. He is also quick with a smile and enjoys a good laugh. His writing had everyone wanting more. Whether creating his next story, picking up a book, or tackling a math problem, his focus helps him achieve great results. Naya Sang. Naya has a fun sense of humor and a playfulness that fills the classroom. She was a dedicated participant in many sports and a number of clubs. Her considerate nature was evident with friends, and she applies the same thoughtful approach to her studies. Tim Wong. Tim joined our school this year. He is a diligent and dedicated student who ensures that his work is as best that it can be. It was nice to see him actively involved in sports and clubs throughout the year. His friendly smile and his willingness to lend a hand have been appreciated. Congratulations, 5H.
I would now like to invite Julian Bazot and Cindy Chen to the stage to present the Grade 5 Legacy Gift on behalf of the Grade 5 class.
It has been a tradition for each grade 5 class to present a legacy gift to the junior school as they prepare to move on to the middle school. There are two parts to this gift. The first is a gift that is chosen by the students in the class. Ideas are suggested and we voted on the best gift to give the junior school to represent our grade and improve the school for students coming behind us. This year, we will purchase a greenhouse for the junior school and some small chairs to go inside. We hope it will become a lovely garden and a quiet outdoor reading space. We feel this represents our love of nature, value for wellness and calm, and will be a lasting gift.
A gift that has been given for the past 3 years highlights the experience of having a musical each year at the junior school. We would like to present the school with a friend trick program and class photo. We feel that it is important to have this experience in the theater, and it's one of the best parts of the year. Shrek will always be a fond memory of our class. On behalf of the grade 5 class, we would like to thank each of the teachers for the work in making the junior school a great experience for us.
And now it is time to enjoy the slideshow prepared one last time by Mr. Chan and Ms. Hope Coulter. Thank you to both of them.
Hi, my name is Jada, and my favorite year was kindergarten because I got my first friend.
I can remember when you fit in the palm of my hand. Felt so good in it, no bigger than a minute. And how it amazes me, you're changing with every blink, faster than a flower blooms. They grow up all too soon.
My favorite year was kindergarten because every day we got free time.
Hi, my name is Naya, and my favorite year in SMU was grade one because I came that year and I met a whole bunch of nice people.
Year at SMU, and Miss Yorath, I remember on my first day, she came and she gave me a really big hug, and that made me feel really welcome here.
Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee, through the park and by the tree. We can rest upon the ground and look at all the bugs we found. safely walk to school without a sound. We safely walk to school without a sound. Well, here we are, no one else. We walk to school all by ourselves. There's dirt on our uniforms from chasing all the ants and worms. We clean up and now it's time to learn. We clean up and now it's time to learn. Numbers, letters, learn to spell. Nouns and books and show and tell. Playtime, we will throw the ball. Then back to class, through the hall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. The teacher marks our height against the wall. We don't notice any time pass, 'cause we don't notice anything. We sit side by side in every class. The teacher thinks that I sound funny, but she likes it when you sing. Tonight I'll dream in my bed while silly thoughts run through my head of the bugs in alphabet. And when I wake tomorrow, I'll bet you and I will walk together again. 'Cause I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
Grade 2 was my best year because we got to make Ukrainian eggs and make gingerbread man.
Hi, my name is Parker, and my favorite year in SMU was grade 3 because, like, genius hour, and we got to know how to survive in the wilderness.
When I saw you wave goodbye, it made me smile while it made me cry. I never thought I'd see the day. I never thought you'd walk a million miles away. But I know we all gotta grow. So these days, everybody wants to find out how the story ends. So we say, nothing is a possibility if you don't got your friends. And I know as time goes by, we're never gonna pretend. 'Cause you and me will always be friends. So if you're feeling all alone, remember good times or remember home. And if you question all that you see, remember that you always got a friend in me. 'Cause I know we all gotta grow. These days, everybody wants to find out how the story ends. So we say, nothing is a possibility if you don't got your friends. And I know as time goes by, we're never gonna pretend. 'Cause you and me will always be friends.
Hi, my name's Peyton, and my favorite year at SMU was grade 3 because we got to do claymation and it was so fun.
Hello, my name is Sophie, and my favorite year was grade 4. It was my favorite year because we did a lot of mindfulness and it helped me to calm down.
Everybody wants to find out how the story ends. So we say, nothing is a possibility if you don't got your friends. And I know as time goes, you'll be fast if I'm slow. And we'll find our tempo, 'cause we may never know how this story ends. But you will always be
story ends. So we say, nothing is a possibility if you don't got your friends. And I know as time goes by, we're never gonna pretend.
Spy Net, where you are part of a spy agency and you have to figure out multiplication and division.
Hi, my name is Elliot, and my favorite year through the school was grade 5 because of all the opportunities we get to do, like the play and others.
Hi, my name's Molly, and my favorite year so far was probably this year in grade 5 because we are part of the Shrek production, and it's really fun to be able to know what it's like to be included in a huge production like this.
Disappointment haunted all my dreams. Then I saw her face.
times or remember home. And if you question all that you see, remember that you always got a friend in me. Cause I know we all gotta grow.
Any closing ceremonies that involve spontaneous songs being sung, I think, is a good thing. Thank you very much, Grade Fives. Thank you very much once again to Mr. Chan and Ms. Hochhalter for that slideshow. It takes hours and hours and careful consideration, and thank you very much for putting that together. Grade Fives, I'd now like to invite you back onto stage. Please stand for the school song.
You can remain standing. Okay, we can sit. Ellie William and I got together last week to reflect on the school year and to decide for what they were feeling grateful. And you came up with a very long list. We condensed that down and created a prayer, and they're going to share it with you now. Please interpret our words in a way that's meaningful to you. Let us pray.
Dear God, it is a privilege to be at a school where there are lots of opportunities for us. We know we are fortunate because there are places in the world where they barely have a school, just benches and lots of children crowded into one room.
Here we have teachers who help us get a good education. They give us choices and help us get through our work, and they always have smiles on their faces. They make it fun with things like figuring out when sushi goes bad and exploding bears.
When we have an accident on the playground, we know we can go to kind people in the front office who will always look after us, whether we need band-aids, ice packs, or a bed to lie on.
We appreciate our facilities. That we have a room for art, a gym for PE, a center for learning, and a lab for our imaginations. This school is a colorful and safe place.
Then there are the other students, our friends. We're thankful that everyone's really friendly and that it's a place where we can grow friendships. Some of us play grounders together, while others sit on the playground donut and talk while we slowly spin ourselves. We're so close that we share things we usually wouldn't talk about.
We know that a lot of people make this possible, including our parents. We appreciate all of their volunteering in the library and on events like Shrek.
For all this, opportunities, staff, facilities, friends, and parents, we're grateful.
Amen. Amen.
This concludes our ceremony for the afternoon. We would like to thank parents, grandparents, and friends of the school for joining us today. We are so pleased to be able to celebrate a joyful year of learning with those wonderful children. We hope that you now join us for refreshments in the quad area outside of the Snowden Library. Please stand as the platform party departs, and I invite the classes to follow, beginning with the grade 4 class. We wish you all a really wonderful summer.